Welcome to our apartment.
Welcome back to the channel, everybody.
Wait, I'm in the process of doing my hair.
Welcome back to the channel, everybody. We are about to do a long anticipated and long overdue video, which is finally a tour of our apartment in New York City, specifically Manhattan. The time has finally come. Do you have anything to say?
Nope, just come for the ride.
So bad. So just a quick disclaimer before we get into the video. Yes, we know it's expensive to live in New York City. Before you comment, you could get a mansion in, you know, Idaho. We know.
Some people love it, some people hate it, some people prefer small town, some people prefer a big city. Yeah. So that's what it comes down to.
It is what it is. So let's get into our apartment tour.
All right, let's go.
Let's go.
Hello?
Can you show me?
Welcome to our apartment.
All right, I know you've all been waiting for this. Well, not really, but we promised you this a year ago. Now that we're moving out, I think it's a good time for us to show you our New York City apartment. We obviously kept it a little bit under the radar just for privacy reasons. So let's get into it.
What do you want to show us first?
Okay, so just a little bit of a background. When we were originally looking to find an apartment, we wanted a two bedroom, one for our bedroom and then the second bedroom being for Michael's desk and studio. However, that comes with a higher cost. So we kind of tried to find a one bedroom apartment that way we were able to have extra room so we could have a desk for Michael. So this is our one bedroom New York City apartment on the Upper East Side. When you walk in, you have the views of New York City. I think what really stole our heart were the views and just the openness, I guess, of the apartment, and then the lighting. There's so much lighting here. It's really hard to top it, and I think lighting is our number one concern when it comes to finding an apartment. So we're gonna go into the kitchen. The one thing that I really wish was a little bit bigger was our kitchen. Like, just a reminder, or like a kind of a backlog, when we got married, we got a ton of new stuff from our wedding, so we don't really have much storage here, so everything is kind of stuffed into all our closet space. So that's the one thing that's just a little bit of a downside. If you love cooking and want a bigger space or bigger kitchen, this apartment may not be for you, but it did the purpose. So let's get into it. So this is our kitchen. This is where I prepped and cooked. Appliance-wise, I really just left two appliances that we constantly use, which is our toaster oven and our coffee machine. I do use our blender quite often, and it's usually I just situate it right along, right over here, and plug it in right there. So it's not really in the space, but I didn't use it for like a week or so I ended up putting it away. We do have a dishwasher, so that's really awesome. And we have a great stove and microwave, so I think having a great stove, like a gas stove, is really awesome. But this, as you can see, the storage space is not really ideal. We really only have this cabinet, and then these cabinets underneath here for all the storage.
What's your favorite part about the kitchen?
I think the view.
Probably the view, yeah.
Yeah, so what's your favorite part of the kitchen?
My favorite part is most definitely the coffee maker.
There's nothing fancy about this coffee maker. I think it's just more aesthetically pleasing.
Yeah, it's actually just really nice. I wanted something to match the all white kitchen, and this is just a cute little white coffee maker. Looks good, functions well, has a timer for me when I wake up early in the morning. It's awesome. There's only like one left when we got it. Still my favorite part of the kitchen to this day.
It would be nice to have an espresso maker and a latte maker and a cappuccino maker, but that comes with counter space, which we don't have. In case you're wondering where else we store all our kitchen stuff, right in this closet, we have our pantry here. This is just a walk-in closet. I put like some metal shelving in there so I can put all our appliances and the rest of the kitchen stuff in there. It also is used to store all of our towels, cleaning supplies, luggages, everything else in there. So it's just not really that organized or worth showing you. Before we get into Michael's office space, this is our little entry, which is great. We have a coat closet and shoe closet. So this is where we store all our coats and shoes. It's nice to kind of have that where we can take off our shoes, hang our coats in the winter time. If it's rainy, if it's snowy, we can leave it out. We're in here. that was really convenient for us. And then of course, very important during the pandemic is instead of key hooks, you have master hooks. When you enter, you have Michael's office. So Michael, do you want to show them your office?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. All right, Dr. Cellini.
All right, so you've seen my desk on probably the desk setup video I did about a year ago. Pretty much nothing has changed. Still have the same dying orchid that's been on here for about a year. Got a new Marshall speaker, which I carry around upstairs to the beach, whatever. But did you have fun? Lost City pill art. That art is made out of pills. Shout out Lost City. And still the 100,000 subscriber plaque, which hopefully that goes to a million soon if you subscribe. So we'll go right over here to my left, since the bar is pretty much in every one of my shots on YouTube. And so many people ask me about this, and so many people have things to say about this. They think I'm an alcoholic, and how could you have this much liquor? But there's a couple explanations for that. And one, we love to entertain people. And when you have 10 plus people over, especially for rooftop drinks, a little foreshadowing for later, you know, you can go through a bottle of liquor through 10 people in no time. So I also like to essentially trade bourbons with my friends, find bourbons that you can't find anywhere else, or ship bourbons that go to other states or that are limited releases. So that's kind of a fun thing we do amongst friends. Where's this bar cart from?
CB2.
I don't know if the link will be in my description because I don't know it.
All right, so now that we already had shown this part of our apartment, we are going to move into the opposite side and our living space. So this is our dining room table. This particular table and chairs are actually the only new thing that we bought for this apartment. Oh, and the bar, because we couldn't fit a table in our old apartment. So we went for a circular table to kind of put it into this little area here. Usually we have fresh flowers, but since we're leaving, there's no fresh flowers. Next is our living room. We have our couch. We have our armchair, our lamp, our basket filled with little blankets. I love, even in the summertime, I always use a blanket on the couch. I think my favorite part of this is just like sitting on the couch at nighttime and just like having the city views behind me. We also have my dead succulent. I still can't keep succulents alive, unfortunately. And our money tree that's actually flourishing. This area right here is unfortunately Michael's also studio space. He has his, what is this called again?
Tripod.
Oh yeah, his tripod. And his light is usually here. He stores everything here, which is gonna be awesome that he has his own studio space in the new apartment. So this stuff is not gonna be in the living room area. I hate when this is shown, but it is what it is.
I don't really have much of a choice.
It is annoying to.
I mean, I have to keep it there. I don't have a closet that can store it, and I don't have anywhere to put it. So that's why I'm so thankful we get to have more space coming up soon.
Next is our entertainment set. We love our Marshall. We always listen to music. Usually on the weekends when we wake up and have coffee or make breakfast. We'll probably get a new TV. This guy has been with us since intern year.
Long time.
So, long time. And then just my books and my cookbooks. Shout out to Half Baked Harvest. I love her. And then my dying peace lily. Can anyone tell me what I do with these brown tips? I don't know what to do for them. Are we supposed to cut them off? If you're interested, this majority of the furniture here is from West Elm. So now that we finish our living room and dining room area, we'll go into the bedroom and bathroom. If you do have any questions on where things are from, I guess just leave them in the comment below and Michael will try to answer them, aka he'll ask me where it's from and...
Ask Andriana on Instagram. Because sure. I don't know the answer.
The only thing I think that's not from West Elm here is this carpet. It's from Overstock. They have such cheap carpets and they look so pretty. So, highly recommend. All right, next we have our mirror. This is where you probably see all of our selfies. This mirror can also go on the floor or it can go against the wall. Ours is against the wall. So that's that. Now we're going into our bedroom. It actually has a decent amount of closet space in it, believe it or not. So when you walk in, we have our bed, our two night tables, with our lamps, and then we have our dresser right here, and then our laundry basket right in this area. So majority of our storage for our clothing is in the closets behind Michael. They are super, super tall, which is great for Michael, but not for me, so I have my little stool to reach all the way inside. Our furniture is from West Elm as well, and then our comforter and duvet cover, actually I should say our duvet cover, and Shams are all from Pottery Barn. We've had this stuff since living in North Carolina as well. We may or may not have contemplating on getting a bigger bed or a new bed for our new apartment, depending on the dimensions, but that's really the only new thing that I think we'll probably update. Maybe, we'll see. One thing that I really hate about, which I'm really excited about, is extra storage space. I hate storing stuff under the bed, which you have to do here, but it is what it is. All right, so next is our bathroom. It is a smaller bathroom. It would be amazing to have two sinks, but this will do. We have our vanity, our toilet, our shower. We have our towels on the towel rack behind here.
Huge bathroom.
Oh, in the new apartment?
No, this one.
Oh, yes, huge. Where do I keep all my stuff? All my skincare is in here, and all my makeup, all my hair and makeup and skin stuff is all in here. Kind of have to make do with what room you have. You just have to like store it in little containers, and that's exactly what I did, just to keep it organized.
You can barely fit two people in there.
Yes. Usually we'll take turns getting ready because it's too small to tolerate two people. Now we'll bring you to our favorite place to spend our free time when we're staying in the apartment. Just an FYI, this building does have amenities such as a gym and a laundry room that's on the third floor. So that's really convenient. You can go do your laundry, and then while you're waiting for your laundry, go work out right across from there. So that makes life a little bit easier and just makes doing laundry a little bit more entertaining, I guess, because you know you can work out in the meantime. We're gonna go head on to the rooftop where we love spending the summertime or when it's really, really nice out. Okay, let's go.
All right, let's go see our rooftop. And this is our fabulous rooftop. Lounge chairs to tan, and then you also have little cabanas to hang with friends, or even to tan underneath there. The views of the city are absolutely gorgeous here. And then on this side, we have
the same views of our apartment.
Yes, the same views of our apartment. And the views of Queens. Back there. And then it extends all the way back here. And then we have an outdoor shower here in case you get very toasty while you're not baking in the sun.
So we have no pool.
Yeah, and that's it.
So that officially concludes our apartment tour and our
building tour.
Hope you all enjoyed it. If you have any comments, leave them below. As always,
smash that like and subscribe button.
Follow me, follow her on YouTube, follow us on Instagram and TikTok.
If you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. And we'll see you all on our next video together. Bye.
Bye.